So here is yet another type of symmetrical scale. This is called the whole tone scale, and the reason for that is that all of the intervals are whole steps. Now, as with the diminished scale, there are a certain set group of notes that work for a whole bunch of different scales. With the diminished scales, there were three different sets of notes. With the whole tone scale, there's only two. So there's really only two groups of notes to learn for this. Then it's just a matter of starting in the right place to get the scale that you want. And actually, probably a better way to think of these is just as groups of notes. That way, when you see a particular chord, you don't have to think, oh, well, I have to start on C and play this scale. It's just a whole cloud of notes that are possible to use. So that might be a more productive way of thinking of this instead of just, you know, starting from a particular note. But that's kind of an easy way to learn them, so that's what I would recommend for learning them. So again, the symmetrical scales has an even pattern between the whole steps and half steps. So for example, the major scale goes whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. So you notice how that's asymmetrical, that's not symmetric. Whereas this particular one is whole step, whole step, whole step, whole step, whole step. Everything's a whole step. Okay, so, and it has this very open, sort of floaty quality to it. So let me just play you the C whole tone scale. Okay, now I'll play you the D whole tone scale, and you'll notice that it's the exact same notes. I'm just starting on D this time. Okay, we can continue up, and so if I start on E, exact same notes, just starting on E. Etc., etc. Start on F sharp, same notes. G sharp, A flat, same notes. B flat, same notes. And then you're back to C again. So that one group of notes, you can play, let's see, one, two, three, four, five, six different scales using those notes. So you have six different chords that you can play that group of notes with. You can play it on C augmented, D augmented, E augmented, F sharp or G flat augmented, G sharp, A flat augmented, and B flat or A sharp augmented. You probably won't see the A sharp very often. So that whole tone scale will work on all of those chords, all six of those chords. Now, if we go up a half step, we get a second group of notes. Okay, so in this case, if I start on C sharp. Okay, again, that floaty, kind of open feel. Then if I start a whole step up, start on E flat. Etc., etc., etc. So again, there are six different scales, or six different chords, that this group of notes goes with. It goes with the C sharp, D flat, augmented. It goes with E flat, augmented, F augmented, G augmented, A augmented, and B augmented. So all of those different chords and scales are basically based, not basically, they're based on the exact same notes, just different starting places or different emphasis. So those are also fun to play. You can do those, you know, like you do the other scales in thirds or different patterns, for example. Haven't done that for a long time, so it's a little rough, but you get the idea. Just make up patterns once you have the basic notes down, and it'll make it a little more interesting, and you can actually throw those into improvised solos, and it'll be fun. So have fun. Good luck with your practice.